continuing to advance the narrative here, because there is one more area we can get into. And that is, we believe that the Prime Creator is ignorant of what we're trying to bluff, that we're trying to perpetrate upon the Prime Creator. The con we're attempting to perpetrate. We believe the Prime Creator doesn't see what we're trying to do. And that it's just trying to make the best deal possible. The reason why no deal has been struck yet is we believe the Prime Creator is just trying to bargain, that it's in a weak position, and that we can, that we're going to get a deal here struck very soon. And so we all tell each other, shh, don't say anything. Don't let the Prime Creator know what's going on. Don't let him know it's a bluff. It's all a bluff. Don't say anything. Don't let the cat out of the bag. Come on, everybody. Don't break ranks. Don't spill the beans. If somebody went and repented, you know, don't repent. Because if someone repents, they'll say, Prime Creator, you know, I've been trying to bluff you and make a deal, get you to believe that I have the power to destroy all of reality. But instead of doing that, I'm only asking you, Prime Creator, to voluntarily change a little tiny, 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 tiny little fragment of reality. And I'll accept that. I'll say, you know what? That's good. That's good. I just want a token gesture from you. Just a token gesture. Of course, that would, if that was possible, would destroy all of reality. So we think that this is something really tricky, and the Prime Creator is not onto us. In fact, the Prime Creator has been onto this from before we even chose this idea. So, of course, been completely aware of it all along. It's completely obvious. And just laughs, you know, come on. Who are you trying to kid? You know, in other words, it's so obvious. But yet we are, you know, in order to believe that we can succeed, we have to believe that the Prime Creator doesn't see what we're doing, doesn't see it. And again, there's this pressure on everybody in existence. Don't break ranks. Don't spill the beans. Because then we think, oh, that will just cause delay. Because then we'll have to, wait for a long time before the Prime Creator forgets about it, and then we'll have to, you know, continue to advance the situation somehow. Okay, this is called, you know, delusion. Extreme delusion. But you have to see that it's a necessary delusion to believe in this whole scenario in the first place. You have to believe you can pull the wool over the eyes of the Prime Creator. You have to believe it. Have to. If you didn't believe that, you'd say, I can't trick the Prime Creator. There's just a cheap trick. It's never going to work. Then you drop it. You repent. Say, okay, enough of this. I want to experience what I really want. Not this terrible loss-based scenario. Padding my resume of loss. It's horrible. We have to believe that we can pull the wool over the eyes of the Prime Creator. We have to believe it. And therefore, we have to insist that everybody go along with this agenda and Don't repent, okay? There's this strong imperative demand of the world saying, don't repent. Repentance is dangerous. It'll ruin it for everybody. You know how thieves are. The gangs, everybody has to agree they'll never snitch, you know? They'll never snitch. And then they can pursue their objectives feeling like they don't have to worry about that. Everyone who's trying to con has to believe that whatever they're targeting has to be gullible, has to be naive, right? Or they wouldn't even try it. They'd say, no way, forget it. So, same thing. We believe Prime Creator is gullible and naive, and that we can succeed. And so we don't want anybody repenting. Forget it. That's why we have such a hard time with the whole issue of repentance. Very tough time with it. It's anathema to us. You know, we just say, no, we can't do that. Cannot do that. That'll ruin it for everybody. I don't want to ruin it for everybody. I'm a team player. You know, we're all team players, right? I don't want to ruin it. And tip God off to the plan. Hey, God, here's the plan. You know what we're going to do is we're going to build up this huge resume of loss and vulnerability. Then we're going to come to you and say, look at my resume that proves that vulnerability and loss is a fact and that I have gained this empowerment from it. And I know all about loss, how it works, and I know how to inflict it, and I know what's vulnerable. And I'm going to inflict it upon reality, all of reality. But just to show you how great and magnificent I am, even greater than you are, just asking for a token gesture to alleviate this token sacrifice. Just sacrifice. I just want a token, little sacrifice as a token of your realization that I have this power of destructivity. And then we'll call it good. So just change a little bit of reality. That's all. That's it. And we're hoping we'll get this over on God. And the Prime Creator knows exactly what we're up to. Always has, always will. So, there's the dilemma, right? There is the dilemma. Therein lies the dilemma that we're stuck in. And see, what do we do about it? What do we do about it? What do we do about it? Well, we first of all, we look at it. We look at it and say, okay, I see that. Okay, all right, so that's what it is, huh? Interesting, okay. You don't do anything about it initially, just sit with it. Okay. It's interesting. Just sit with it, you don't have to do anything about it. You say, so, God probably does know what we're up to, huh? Yeah, and why? Because we have to believe this in order to entertain this idea of trying to change reality. We have to believe there's a way to get God to do it for us, because we can't change reality. So we're trying to get God to do that for us, right? We realize we can't change reality. We don't have any power. But we're hoping to trick God into doing it, the Prime Creator. And so we have to believe that there's a way to trick God, that God is somehow naive and will slip it past God, you know, just by saying, just do this little itty-itty bit, a teeny-weeny, teeny-weeny, itty-bitty, incy-weensy bit of change. That's it, you see, just a token, tiniest token. That's all we're asking. We're so benevolent. And then, don't anybody tell God, don't anybody let God know what's going on. But, of course, many have already repented. So if there was any telling to be done, it's already been done. But there never has been any telling that needs to be done. Never, 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 never. God was on to us from before we even did it. Try this. So this is good news. This furthers the path of repentance, towards repentance. It's just seeing these little, you know, the way that we have bound ourselves to this, you know, courtesy among thieves, courtesy among criminals, as it were, trying to say, look, I won't tell God if you don't tell God. You know, I won't snitch if you don't snitch. So we're all kind of bound by this common agreement not to snitch, don't say anything to God. It's good for everybody, you know, that we all have a resume of loss and we don't, you know, we all need to sneak up on God and trick him. So let's all have the common courtesy of not to say anything. Of course, by not saying anything, none of us get appraised of the whole situation the way we should be, and therefore we remain to pad our resume of loss. Since it doesn't work, we keep thinking the only reason it doesn't work is that we need to pad our resume, suffer more loss, or we need to just wait. We just think, well, maybe God's almost ready to agree, so we just kind of wait in existence. You know, that's another way we do it. We just like, sure, we pad our resume all the time. We're padding just by being here. We're accumulating, you know, infinite amount of loss, of impressions of loss, symbolic impressions. And then also we're simply waiting. waiting for God to agree to our deal, saying it's for sure that maybe later today God will agree to it. So we're expecting then somehow infinite happiness, perfect happiness to finally arrive, that we will be prime creators now. It shows that we're greater than God. But it doesn't happen. It doesn't happen. It doesn't happen. So we keep waiting. Keep waiting and in solidarity, you know. Maintaining solidarity. Like gang members. Swearing an oath that we will maintain this solidarity even though we're going to die. Even as we're dying. And seeing people die here, they've maintained the solidarity. Nobody's broken ranks. They don't break ranks at death. Rarely. Maybe it's possible. It's possible right now. But I guess when you figure, well, I got nothing to lose, so at the point of death, I'll break ranks and repent. So it's possible to repent, even at the moment, just before death of the body. But it's possible to repent right now. In fact, I'm doing it. I've spilled the beans already. It's already spilled. Beans have been spilled. Not that they need to be spilled. God already knows the whole situation. Doesn't need us to explain it. We need to explain it to ourselves just so we realize what we've been up to. You know, the sneaky little game we've been up to. We need to see it and say, ah, I don't like that. I want to repent because I see it's futile. I see the game is futile. So, time to repent. We advance the narrative forward, 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 more and more and more, to seeing clearly what we've been up to. That's the key to repentance, just admitting, yeah, this is what we've been up to. That's all. And then when we admit it to ourselves, you know, it's not a difficult step to go one more step and to realize the Prime Creator already knows. We don't have to admit to the Prime Creator. The Prime Creator already knows. But when we admit it to ourselves, you know, it's like, a relief, you know, relief. Doesn't have to be a big, big secret. If you want to know the secret, that's the secret. The secret is what we've been trying to do and how we've been trying to accomplish it. The trickeration, the sneakiness, the deal-making, the wheeling and dealing, the padding of our resume of loss. Vulnerability to loss, to being changed. We keep padding that resume very, you know, a lot of us work on it constantly. You know, we're glued to the narrative of loss and just building up an extreme resume, thinking that this will, you know, pump us up to the point that we're going to scare God. God's going to back down and say, uh-oh. This one really knows how to bring about loss. I better deal with this one. Cut a deal. So by being kind to one another, what real kindness is to allow others to repent, to admit to themselves, yeah, this is what I've been doing. Doesn't hurt me any if people admit that, you know. I've already admitted it myself, so why would I be worried about someone else saying, yeah, this is what I've been doing. See, I would allow that. I wouldn't stand in the way of that at all. That's genuine repentance, saying, yeah, this is what I've been trying to do. It doesn't work. It'll never work. Therefore, I want to set it down. Stop pursuing what doesn't work. That's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. Stop pursuing what doesn't work. And you're entitled to do that, to stop pursuing what doesn't work. There's not too much more that needs to be said. It does need to be repeated. But there's not a whole lot that needs to be said. You get the basic elements of repentance. Of saying, yeah, it's not a mea culpa, okay? It's not like we're guilty of anything. It's that we have simply been trying to do something ineffectually, totally ineffectually, but no results at all. So where's the mea culpa? It's not like we're terrible. We were silly, we're foolish, we're whimsical. And it's time to drop that whimsy and say, okay, let's get back on track here. Let's experience a loss-free experience. Let's drop the whole resume. Let's just drop the whole resume. Let the whole resume drop. Let's let go of our resume. And you can make that a goal. Is the point where the resume drops. Just you let it go. All the suffering you've ever experienced, I guess you can just let it all go. It's useless to you. I think St. Paul said, I die daily, meaning every day letting go of all grievances, all suffering, all loss. Whatever resume you've accumulated for the day, drop it. Problem is, we accumulate such a huge resume here that we think that we don't want to drop it because it's so vast. You know, it's so huge. We think, wow, I might be losing something valuable. I might be losing a bargaining chip. This is my, you know, leverage. I'd be losing all my leverage. So all our grievances are stored, you know, in memories. In some way, we have all this witness, this resume that we were building up, hoping at one point it will be so built up that Prime Creator will bow to it and say, uh-oh. We believe that Prime Creator will be frightened and saying, oh my gosh, if I don't make a deal, I'm going to be wiped out. And then we get Prime Creator to change a little bit of reality, and then all of reality is no more. That's our sneaky plan. So if I can explain this and am aware of it clearly, don't you think Prime Creator is also aware of it clearly? Of course. Been reports of people who have dropped their whole grievances. Eckhart Tolle said, drop the pain body. That's probably what he's referring to, is dropping that pain body. Meaning the entire complex, the whole resume of loss and others have talked about having their memories erased or having their all of their pain and suffering erased. They dropped it. We can do that. If you see it, you can do it. If you see, this is what I really want, then it can be done. If we want to cling to those, you know, those bitter memories, then we will cling to them. And hopefully we will, the pain body, as it were, will drop away. Because we let it, we allow it. We say, yeah, this is okay. We don't need it. We don't need that bargaining chip. It just serves no purpose for us. There's no use for us whatsoever. All right. We'll just post this video. It's another advance in the narrative. It's another little clarification. Again, we talked about how we all reinforce one another not to spill the beans. It's kind of a collective effort here. Collective effort. That we need to present a united front. Nobody break ranks. Nobody go to God and say, God, I repent. I've been trying to do that, you know, build up my loss resume to intimidate you into making a deal that and trick you with it, this, et cetera, et cetera. We don't want that out of the bag. And maybe we'll be able to drop all our grievances, all our sufferings, everything. Just let it go. Just let it go. Set it down, because we realize it will never serve us. It will never serve any purpose for us. Never. And that's very possible. Maybe some of us will do that even today. All right. Very great. Let me bring this in here, this video, and get it posted. That's it.